prophetic word, a direct word, word of wisdom, word of knowledge. So someone, or someone who's listening today, and I had to get to you today. I had to get to you today, and I want to say this. The title of this direct word that I want to speak to you is that you cannot move forward looking back. And I will say this, that many that listen to me, and you're listening to me, you're looking back. You're looking back at your past. You're looking back at what you once was. You're looking back at all of that. And, you know, you'll never be successful thinking about things that defeated you. And so that's what it is. Matter of fact, let me turn this down. I hear God. The many of you that listen to me, you will never move forward looking back and see what it is. Many of you, you're entangled. You're trapped. It's like you got yourself in some kind of spider web, some kind of web. You're entangled in some kind of web and you can't get out. It's like you went in there looking around, but while looking around and you're trying to get out, and now that you can't get out, you're stuck. Some of you regret certain places you've been, certain things you've done. You regret it. And what's interesting is what's interesting, the regret is eating away at you. The sound of the regret is greater than the actual situation itself now. Where you at right now, what you don't realize that you're free. God has made you. He didn't and presented the thing. It'll present an avenue where you can be free. Scripture says that those who are in Christ Jesus, new creature, all things have passed away, behold, all things become new. You are a new creature when you accepted God, when you ask God to help you, when you ask God to fix this thing, you ask God to come in and take the wheel. Help come. And when your help come, then why are you still trying to fix it? Why are you still trying to fix it? If help has come, why are you still trying to fix it? Many of you, there's a situation that God has been speaking to you to leave alone, but you keep touching it. And every time you keep touching it, it's almost like barbed wire, or the barbed wires, or those electrical wires. If you touch it, it's gonna stick you, sting you, or bite you. It's gonna sting you, bite you, not bite you, but it's gonna sting you, or it's gonna shock you. And so many of you are being stung and shocked because you keep touching what you've been told not to touch. You've been told not to touch, but you're doing it anyway. Just like with the man and the woman, Adam and the woman, they were told not to touch the tree. Touched it anyway. And when they touched it, their eyes came open. Their eyes came open to the truth, what they thought was the truth. But what happened, shame came. When they disobeyed God, shame came. And from that shame, they hid themselves. Did you know that after they sinned, and after they sinned, they hid themselves. The better not, God was coming through the cool evening like he do every evening, coming through looking for Adam. Adam hidden. Adam, where are you? So the scripture said that the Spirit of the Lord, the voice of the Lord was walking through the evening, cool of the evening. Where are you? Spirit of the Lord walking through the evening, cool of the evening. Adam hiding. And God said, who told you were naked? He said, I'm naked. And as soon as he said that, who told you were naked? You know what he did? That Adamic nature, that Adam nature, he pointed the finger at his wife. Well, that woman he gave me. Look at the woman, that serpent. And see, that's the thing that God wants to kill. That Adamic nature where you won't face the consequences. You won't face the consequences, but you'll hide. God do not want you to hide. Are you listening to me? This is a direct word for someone. God do not want you to hide. He wants you to stop covering yourself up, covering stuff up. See, that's the thing what Adam did. After he sinned, he covered himself up from the shame. Many of you are covering up, you're painting your face, you're doing all kind of stuff to try to drown out or change the picture of what you see in your mind, what you see. But God is saying, stop drowning stuff out. Because when God told him he was naked, and he found out he was had uncovered himself some fig leaves, God killed a lamb. He killed a lamb and poured the blood out. But after he poured the blood out, he took the sheepskin, he took the skin and used it as garments to protect him and to cover him. You need to know that God gave the only sacrifice that you need to give. He gave the ultimate sacrifice of death to take on the likeness of sin. Your shame, your excuses, my excuses. He took it all on and he removed it. And so you don't have to accept that. You don't have to accept the sin. You don't have to accept none of that. Now check this out. In Hebrews, the book of Hebrews, the 12th chapter and the first verse. Scripture says that seeing that we can pass by so great cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and sin that does so easily beset us and run the race that's set before us with patience. In that, there's one translation, I think it's the New International, says that lay aside every weight and sin that so easily besets us, but lay aside the weight and sin that so easily entangled. You done got yourself entangled in. You done got yourself, lay aside every weight and sin that you done got yourself entangled in. So you got to entangle, detangle. And just like, as an example, I, for the most part, do my daughter's hair before school every morning. And I tell you, and her hair is coarse. It's coarse. You know, because she's a copper colored, and because, you know, she has a certain type of hair, it gets tangled. It gets tangled, it gets difficult, and so I got to put some kind of solutions on it to untangle it. And so a lot of times in the morning, it's like from her sleeping. Now, before she went to sleep, the hair looked nice. But from her going to sleep to waking up, it's like it was a wrestling match with her hair. Because once she wake up, I'm like, my God. And so what I do, I pull the water and a little stuff in it, a little comb, and try to have to pull the hairs apart, pull all the hair apart to untangle her hair with a little water, a little solution. She'll fight me a little bit, you know. I talk to her, give her a little something to drink, a little something to nibble on, and get her mind off of doing the hair. And I part it down the middle, you know, fix her work on and stuff like that. And don't judge me, you know, see her hair. I do my best. But, so what I do, I untangle her hair every morning. But that nighttime through her sleeping, her resting, tossing and turning, rolling, that's what makes her hair tangled up. And many of you that listen to me, that's what's happened to you from the rousal, from the hurt, from the fight, from the fear, from being criticized, ostracized, feeling alone, feeling rejected. It's a wrestling match. When you think about your past, when you think about the things that you go through, it's a wrestling match. And if you keep thinking about it long enough, it's going to have you tangled up in it. That's why Jesus said, take heed how you hear. Because if you hear wrong, if you hear the words of seeds, and if you're not careful, those words will become entangled up in those words. You'll become stuck. You become bound. You become trapped, like in a prison. Many of you are trapped in a prison from words. You're trapped in a prison from emotions. You are, and oftentimes, without emotions, the enemy, familiar spirits of our past, will attach itself to our emotion, especially when something makes us upset. There is a spirit that will attach to our emotions and gas and heighten the thing that we're emotional about. You need to know that the enemy, Satan, he's the accuser of the brother. So in other words, he's going to accuse. In your mind, the thoughts that you get, they're going to be accusing somebody else. They're going to be accusing somebody else of beating you down. When he speaks to you, there ain't going to be no life, ain't going to be nothing that's going to make you feel good. It's going to be stuff that's going to beat you down. That's going to keep you entangled in a web where you can't get out. And see, that's what the enemy wants. The enemy wants you to be lost in his way of lost in pain, lost in hurt, lost in the past. Lost there. And see, many of you, you're lost there, but God has a way back, and his name is Jesus. There's a way back. His name is Jesus. And he said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. It's written in the scriptures. Jesus, that there's no other name given on earth whereby we can be saved except name Jesus. Not Buddha, not none of that stuff, but Jesus. He's the Son of God. He came to redeem man back. I don't know if he knew that. The death, burial, and resurrection of him. The scripture said, whosoever shall call on his name, John 3:16, they shall be saved. And if I'm calling on his name, according to the scripture, I'm going to be saved. Then it's very important that I do it. It's very important that you do it. And whatever kind of situation that you find yourself in where you feel as though you're bound, you're in prison, you're entrapped, all you got to do is call on his name. If you call on his name, and whatever kind of situation you're in, he will deliver you. He said, if you call me, I answer. I hope this word has helped, and it's helping someone. You got to get past the past. Those past ways, past thoughts, past feelings, how you used to be, oh, get back to the old me. The old you, that's the past. You can't recapture that. You got to move forward. You want to be better. You want to be the old you. You want to be the better you. Don't be the old you. Let the dead bury the dead. Have a funeral for that past, because when you hold on to the past, what's going to happen is going to stink. It's going to stink. If you keep holding on to the past, it's going to stink. Because what happens, scripture says that unless a root of bitterness springing up in you, whereby many be defiled. So scripture tells to follow peace with all men. Because if you don't, then bitterness and hate and all that stuff is going to creep in. And once it settles, it's going to come in order. Don't let stuff in your life settle. Don't let hate, don't let hurt. If you know that you have an issue with someone, go reach out. Talk to them. Fix it. God is pleased with that. God is pleased. Just to let you know, let me say a quick word of prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, give us a forgiving heart, a forgiving mind, a forgiving soul. God, create us a clean heart and renew within us a right spirit. God, bless us individually, collectively. God, bless us like you said you're going to bless us, God. And God, until you bless us, God, we're going to trust you. God, we're going to wait right here until you troll our waters. Could you change our situation, God? God, some that listen to me, they got a situation that needs to be changed. They got some hurt that needs to be removed. They're like their corner. Their back is against the wall. Stuff is coming in high pursuit. And God, they need you like never before. And God, show up. As you said in your word, God, you're a very present help in time of trouble. And God, there's some trouble here. There's some trouble in the home. There's some trouble in their mind. There's some trouble in their body. There's some trouble in the relationship. There's some trouble going on, God. God, but I thank you that trouble don't last always, God. God, because you're troubling the water right now and you're bringing healing. God, you're bringing healing to every painful situation, God. For those that hear this word, and receive the word in this word. Get down in their spirit and leap and bring healing. You said in your word, the same spirit that raised up Jesus Christ from the dead shall quicken our mortal body, God. Quicken us. God, come us, God, calls us to come alive, God, in every dead place, every place that's sleeping, God. That those that listen to me, every painful place, every place, scarred, rejected, God, revive, bring healing, God. Send your healing self. Concerning their situation, concerning their heart. God, change, change, change. Heal, heal, heal. Deliver, deliver. Set free. God, teach them how to lay it aside. Lay aside the trouble. Lay aside the hurt. Lay aside every rejection, every mistake. And let that shame go. And come to the Master. For the Master has need of you. For God, I thank you, God, that you're calling us, God. You're calling us to the feast. And God, you're telling us to come. Coming to you all that weary and heavy laden, then you will give us that rest, God, and we're looking for that rest, God. Give us rest where we're restless, God, where we're fighting, God, where we're bucking, where we're uneasy, God, where we're fighting, and panic attacks, anxiety, God, bring peace. Calm our spirit. God, cause that word to speak, to be deep in our heart, that when troubles come, we don't sin against you. And so, God, for that reason, God, we thank you and bless you. God bless everyone that come here to listen today. Bless them with something special. Give them a special blessing. Something that they've been playing for. Something that they've been hoping for. God calls that hope to materialize. God calls that hope to come to pass now. According to your word and according to your will. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And amen. And so, for those of you who have received a message, say, put in the comment, I received a message. I received a message. I received a man. I received a word. I received a word. If you receive this word, put in the comment, I received a word. I receive it. 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 Don't think about what you didn't receive. Don't think about what you didn't have. Don't think about what you didn't get. Receive. Receive. Don't think about what you didn't do. Don't think about what you got locked out of. Don't think that the door got slammed in your face. Don't look for the negative. But just say, God, I receive. Can you don't look at the past? Well, it didn't happen last time. Well, it's not last time. This is right now. The scripture said today. Now faith is the substance of things. But for right now, your substance is right now. See, faith is substance spiritually. You can't see it naturally, but spiritually. So, and when you get a new set of eyes, when you see according to the spirit, the eyes of faith through scripture, through reading, you have a relationship with God, then you'll be able to receive what it is that you're asking God for. The scripture says, Jesus said all through the Bible, all through scripture, according to your faith, not your mama's faith, not your daddy's faith, but your faith, be it done unto you. Is that all right? God bless you. Good morning.